We are gearing up right now for a lot to happen this week, and we turn to our guy, Elliotte Friedman, NHL Network insider. Let's start off with Erik Karlsson and that massive deal that he just signed with the Sharks. What's the impact it has on the free agent defensive class?
You know, I think significant. I think that having Erik Karlsson coming off the list means that you're going to see the next level of guys, the Tyler Myers, the Jake Gardiners, the Alex Edlers. They probably had like a small smile on their faces the next after that was done, because they're the next level guys. And, you know, that's good that you show the other side there. The guys who have one more year remaining, Tyson Barry, Torrey Krug, Roman Josi. You think that Roman Josi in particular isn't going to have a big raise after next season? I think those kinds of players who are a year away, I think that the impact on them is going to be enormous. It's hard to find defensemen. There's a lot of teams looking for them, and I think those players are going to benefit. I think we've been wondering in particular, like, Yossi's not getting traded. I don't think Torrey Krug's getting traded, but I think Tyson Barry is a guy teams are asking about, and depending on what Colorado wants to do, he could be traded.
Elliotte, we're talking about impact as well with the Rangers and their move yesterday, picking up Jacob Trouba from the Jets. New York already has a lot of cap space. How active do you think they might continue to be during free agency?
Well, I think they're going to have a lot of options. I don't think there's any question about that. I can't imagine it's going to be a big problem for them to get Trouba done. He's a player they've liked, they've coveted. I got to think that they're going to get a deal done with him, and he's going to be the anchor of their blue line to come. I think the biggest thing is going to be, for example, what they did. First of all, what do they decide to do with a player like Chris Kreider? One more year, very reasonable salary until he's an unrestricted free agent, a guy who can help a lot of teams. Like, this was a tough playoffs. It reminded people that you need to have physical power in order to be successful. And if they want to put Kreider on the market, there's going to be a lot of interest in him. You know, Panarin, I think a lot of people believe he's going to Florida. That was potentially a New York target. I think New York's going to have a lot of ability to do a lot of things. And I think creative using their cap space and picks. Do they want to strike for next season? I think that might be tough for them.
All right, how about the Flyers, who get another defenseman as well, picking up Justin Braun from the Sharks? I guess I'll ask it this way. Who do you think this trade benefits more?
Well, I think in terms of a player, Justin Braun can help Philadelphia. They've really changed their blue line in the last couple of days. Matt Niskanen had a down year in Washington, but I'm a Matt Niskanen fan. I think he's got more to live. More to give. Justin Braun, you know, he's a guy who in the playoffs, they went back to him. He saw some 20-minute games, especially as the playoffs went on, and I thought he kind of looked a bit more like himself. I always like getting guys in the last year of their contract, because he's going to have something to prove if he wants a big deal for next year. So I like this pickup for Philadelphia based on San Jose needing to move out players. I think the other thing that's really interesting for Philadelphia is I think they've got a big offer. I don't know if Philadelphia was Kevin Price, but I think they've made him an offer that at the very least has made him think, if I turn this down, am I going to be able to do somewhere else better? And I don't know if the answer is yes.
All right, before I let you go, we got to talk about the salary cap negotiations. We hear all these murmurs about what's going to happen. So fill me in. What do you think is going to happen?
Well, I think we're going to get an announcement sometime this weekend. The Board of Governors is here in Vegas. They meet tomorrow. I know they're going to be talking about it, but I think we'll get an announcement this weekend. I'm expecting that this year's cap, I don't think it's going to hit that projected $83 million. I think it's going to be somewhere between $81.5 million and $82 million, and the next big jump will come after 2020, 2021, when the new US TV deal comes into place. That's my prediction.
Elliotte, you're the man. Keep up the great work. We'll talk soon.
All right. Just keep making them up like the best of them. That's what I try to do.
There he is.